Hello everyone, and in today's tutorial we will create a beautiful night city. And let me explain how we'll do it. We will be using Python programming language along with a Turtle graphic library to create our beautiful buildings. But first, a look at this beautiful night city. And the most exciting part is every time it generates you a new city. So it's a random buildings. You can see it creates a random color with a random height. Every time you run this program, you will get a new night city. So let's get started. We will start with a blank file. Create a new file, name it night city. .py. So as I mentioned, we are using the Turtle graphic library and we will use a random function as well. The first thing we need to do, we need to import Turtle and random library. From Turtle star, we'll import all the functions of the Turtle graphic library. So the same we'll do for random. From random import star. So the next thing we need to set up our screen. So screen equals get screen. And we will set dimension of the screen. Screen.setup. And I'll create my screen 800 to 600. That's big enough. I'll set a black background as we are building a night city. Screen.vg color black. Black. Screen.vg color black. And I'm done. Let's test it out and see our black screen. Okay, black screen is created as expected. The next, what we're going to do, night sky. So with lots of stars. Stars usually they are placed on a random position. So we will use our random function to put dots on a random position. We would create, let's say, 300 stars. So basically we repeat same actions over and over again, so that's definitely used for for loop. Or underscore, because we are not gonna use this variable in range 300. Let's check it out if 300 is enough for us. And I need to put a dot on a random position. So basically I need to have a random x coordinate and a random y coordinate. I'll get this random position as rand int. And as my screen width is 800, so I want to build it along the screen. So basically 800, it's a whole screen. So half of a screen minus 400 to 400. I want it to be from minus 400 to 400. And the y coordinate would be at top of our screen because we are building a sky. We don't want any stars on the ground. That's why rand int. Our screen is 600, so 0 is in the middle of a screen. So we want it, let's say, minus 50 to 300. After that, we need to put a dot. So we're doing pan up, so we don't want to see any lines. Go to x, y coordinate, we don't pan down, and after that we put a dot. So it's dot, size of the dot is 1, and color is white. We created a for loop, which will execute 300 times, and we'll put a dot on a random position. Let's test it out and see. Can you see it's putting a dot? The next command I'll do, I'll set a speed. I'll set it to speed 0. It's a max speed. So our drawing would be created faster. I'll put a speed and tracer. Add our tracer, let's say 2, speed 0. So now it should be much faster. Can you see? Now we've got a nice, beautiful night sky. So the next step is to create our buildings. Building is nothing else like a rectangle. So we will create a function to create a rectangle, and then we reuse this function to build a city. So next step is to create a function. I'll create it before our sky using div, and I name it rectangle. So to create a rectangle, we would need to know initial position. Where is that drawing rectangle? It's x and y coordinate. We also need to know height and width. So it's h and w. And also every time I want to build my buildings a different color. So I need a color. I select the color. Color is color. We will define a list of a color then later. Color. Then I need to go to initial position. Pen up. I put a pen up. I move to my initial position. If I go to command X, Y, and I set a pen down. So from this point, I can start drawing. How we draw a rectangle? So basically, we draw a line forward, then we turn 90 degrees, and draw another line forward. So basically, it's width and height. And then we repeat it twice. So I'll create a for loop and repeat it twice. For in range 2. In range 2. So we repeat it twice. So we're going forward. We're going forward for our width. After that, we need to turn. We can turn left 90 degrees or right 90 degrees. I'll turn left. Left 90 degrees. And then we're going another forward line, drawing another line forward for our height. And turn another left 90 degrees. That's how we draw our rectangle, but we also want to fill it with a color. That's why before this, I'll say begin fill. Begin fill, and after finish drawing on the same level with a for loop, I say end. After our night sky, I'll call this rectangle. Rectangle. So now I need to specify x and y coordinate. Let's say x, my initial x would be minus 200. My initial y, minus 200 as well. Then I need to say what's the height and width. Height, let's do 250, and width, 90. And color, I'll say gray color. Let's test it out and see if it draw a rectangle for us. Yeah, can you see a rectangle? So we can see a single rectangle. So now we want to build multiple buildings, so which is standing one after another. We will be reusing this rectangle function to do this. We need to have some nice colors at the top of my screen before my function. I'll create a list of colors I would like to use. You can use any other colors whenever you like. So V color, it's a building color, list of colors. Let me use olive. I'll use orange. I'll use gray, dark gray, red color as well. And I'll create another list for our window color. We also will create a window on each of the building. And as it's a night view, we get some warm colors for window color. And I'll have yellow. It's cute. Actually, it's a very nice color. And I'll have a black color. Here, instead of saying the color, I can pick a random color from my list of the colors. How I do this? I'll say choice and my list name, building color, B color. Now we're testing it and we see it's a light gray color. If I run my program once again, I You see, it's a different color. I'll remove this line because we're going to using a while loop to calculate how many buildings we can fit in our screen. So initial position of an X coordinate, I'll put as minus 400 because our screen is 800, zero in the middle, so it means minus 400 one way and 400 other way. So we will start from one side and initial X, I'll set as minus 400. Then I create a while loop. While, and I'll say while X coordinate is less or equals 400, that's the other end of our screen. So every time we create a building, we will change the X coordinate because each building will be next to each other. We need to have initial Y coordinate. Every time we create a building, we want to have it a random height. So the height, that's the height we send to our rectangle. Height, we make it random, we say rand int, and the shortest building you want to have is 150, and the highest building, let's say 500. Okay, so we've got 600. I think it's too much, so let's say the highest building is 400. We call our rectangle. Rectangle, we set X, we set Y coordinate. Next we have width, height, so we width, height and color, yeah, so we'll specify. So now width, with a width we will keep all the building the same width, let's say 90. And for the color we already discussed, we will pick a random color from our building color list. So basically we change this to choice building color. Let's say we start creating our buildings. We created the first one on position X, Y, and our building is 90 in width. So the next building, actually, we need to move our X coordinate to this 90 pixels. So basically, after we're done, X coordinate is changing. Plus equals 90. Let's test it out and see if we have a nice buildings. So, but they are all the same length. Means we... Oh, because the first is height, second is width. So I need to have height first and width over here. Now it should work. Yeah. So now, can you see we have the buildings? Nice buildings. Every building is a different color and they are different height. The next step is to create a windows on both buildings. Same way, we're going to reuse our rectangle, but we need to calculate how many windows we can fit in our building. So it basically would be for loop in a for loop. For window, window in range. And now our range is our height. And our window, I'll create it, let's say 10 by 20. So basically we need to have some gap between windows. Then we're adding 10 more. So we're saying height divided by 30. In this case, we know how many rows we need to create. And the next one, we need to specify how many in a single row. So for I in range, the range is from 10 to 90. Every time have a step 20 because the 20 is our size of a window. The next one we create is our rectangle, and in this rectangle, when they create a window, we don't want to stick it to our side of the building, so we want to have a little gap. This gap is 10. Yeah. Next, we know what's the width of our building is 90. So basically, it's till 90. And then 20 is the size of our building, size of our window. That's why it's 20 here. And they create a rectangle. Every time it's, we start from x plus I. Initially I, this number, it's 10. The next, it would be 30 because it's adding 20. And so on. And then we need to know our y coordinate. Y coordinate, we also adding 10. For y, we don't want it to be on the very bottom. Every time we will add 10, so to have a gap. Y plus 10. Next, we say height. Height is 20, we discussed, and we say width. Width will be 10. And next is a color. So now we select the color from our window color list. It would be choice. And window. After we've done this basically three times, we need to change our y coordinate to create a second row of the window. So our y coordinate would be increasing by 30. Here we indicated 30, as we know it's 20 height and we want 10 gap. So it's basically 30. Basically created our beautiful night city. Let's test it out and see if it is working. Okay, we've done something wrong. Yes, the mistake is with a Y. I need to put it inside the while loop. Let me check. Yes, because the Y here, in this case, is unchanged. And it always minus 250, but we are changing Y coordinate. That's why it should be inside the while loop. Initially I done a mistake, so we are moving our y inside a while loop. So now if we run it once again, here, you see it creates a different night though. So now what we can do, we can change our colors to add some nice colors. You can add any list of colors. I'll use some very nice colors and change it to, and let's check it out. So now we have more variety of colors. And our beautiful town looks great. Next time I run it, I'll get absolutely different town. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thank you. Bye.